Hi crafters, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Altea. Today I have a very interesting project because I will show you how you can crochet our Mother Mary. So I will hope you enjoy this video. If you do, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel down below. And as always, are you ready to get hooked? For today's project, I will need cotton yarn, some pins, a yarn needle, stitch markers, a scissors, and a 2.5mm hook. I will start off with a magic ring. I will pass the needle from beneath, yarn over, and pull it through. And we have a magic ring. I will single crochet 6 into this magic ring. This one. To single crochet, you simply go through the loop, yarn over, pull it through, yarn over, and pull it through. You can count your stitches by counting the V's that you can see at the top. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 V's. That means we have 6 single crochets. We'll pull our chain close to create a circle. And I will now crochet in the round. For the first round, I will single crochet twice into each stitch. So that's the first stitch. And the second single crochet into the same stitch. I will use a stitch marker to show me the beginning of my row. And I will repeat 2 single crochets into each stitch. Go ahead and pause the video wherever you need to catch up. Once you have reached your stitch marker, that means that you are at the end of row. For my next row, I will single crochet once into the first stitch and 2 single crochets into the next, and I will repeat it until my stitch marker. So that's my first stitch, which I single crochet once, and in my next stitch, I will now single crochet twice. Repeating this until the end of my row. For my third row, I will single crochet once in my first two stitches, and I will single crochet twice in my third, and repeat this until the end. For my next round, I will single crochet once into the first three stitches, and I will single crochet twice into the fourth stitch. When you single crochet twice into the same stitch, it is also called an increase. Next, I will single crochet in the first 4 stitches and make an increase in the 5th. Next, I will single crochet into the first 5 stitches and then I can increase. For my last increase round, I will single crochet in the first 6 stitches and make an increase in my 7th stitch. Once our increasing rounds are done, I will single crochet all around, but first, for my first single crochet round, I will single crochet in the back loop only. To find your back loop, you will take the loop which is facing outwards. Pass the hook in the middle, yarn over, and single crochet. Repeat this all around, and this will create an edge for our base. Once you single crochet in the back loops only, all around. I will single crochet for 14 rows in total. Once your 14 rows of single crochets are done, you will start decreasing. I have cut a circular board to place at the bottom so our Mary can stand still. I will start stuffing it as I go along. Now I will single crochet in the first 6 stitches and I will make a decrease in the 7th. To make a decrease, you will go from the first front loop then the back loop of the next stitch, yarn over, pull it through, yarn over and pull it through. Now I will single crochet all around for 3 rounds total. I will be single crocheting in between each decrease so we will grow our body. Once the 3 rounds of single crochets are done, I will single crochet in the first 5 and make a decrease. Once done, I will single crochet another 3 rounds until our next decreasing round. For my next decreasing round, I will single crochet in the first 4 and then make a decrease. Once done, I will single crochet around for 3 rows total. Next, I will single crochet into the first 3 stitches and make another decrease. Once done, I will single crochet around for 3 rows total. Always stuff as you go along. I will be using a pipe cleaner folded in order to have our head steady and upright on our body. This will avoid having our head hanging. For our final decreasing round, I will single crochet in the first 2 stitches and then decrease. Once this is done, I will just single crochet 1 row in total. Next, I will single crochet once and then another decrease. In order for our Mary to hold its shape, stuff it as much as you can. Place in the pipe cleaner and stuff around it as tight as possible to hold its place. Next, we will move on to the head, so we will change our color from white to a skin color. To change color, I will simply go through my loop and yarn over in my new colored yarn. And single crochet as usual. Single crochet all around in the new color. For my next round, I will single crochet and increase in the front loops for this round only. This will start shaping the head outwards. For the next round, I will single crochet in the first two stitches and make an increase. And for my next one, I will single crochet the first three stitches and make an increase. Now I will single crochet in the first 4 stitches and then increase. Next, I will single crochet in the first 5 stitches and then I can increase. And finally, for our final increasing round, I will single crochet into the first 6 stitches and then increase. Now I will be single crochet all around for 10 rows in total. Once the 10 rows of single crochets are done, we will start decreasing and closing in our head. So for the first decreasing round, I will single crochet into the first 6 stitches and make a decrease. Repeating this all around. Now into the first 5 stitches and make a decrease. Single crochet into the next 4 stitches and then make a decrease. Stuffing the head as tight as you can to form the circular shape. Single crochet into the first 3 stitches and a decrease. and single crochet into the first 2 stitches and then a decrease. Next, I will single crochet once and then another decrease. Sew it closed and weave in the end. Keep stuffing it tightly as by time it might lose its shape. To make the cloak, I will be using a blue yarn and a 3mm hook. This is slightly larger from the 2.5 just for our cloak to fit on the head that we just created with our 2.5mm hook. And I will start off with a magic circle and single crochet 6 into this magic circle. Once the magic circle is done, I will single crochet twice into each stitch. I will be single crocheting around the same as I did to create the base of the body of Mary. I will single crochet into the first stitch and then make an increase. Now I will single crochet into the first two stitches and then make an increase. Single crochet into the first three stitches and then increase. Next, I will single crochet into the first four stitches and then make an increase. Now single crochet into the first 5 stitches and then increase. And single crochet into the first 6 stitches and then increase. Now single crochet all around for 6 rows in total. As you can see, since we did the same increases but changed the hook for a slightly larger one, this fits perfectly on our head. Now we will start building the cloak. I will now be single crocheting back and forth, but not all the way through. So single crochet into the first 24 stitches. Once you're in your 24th stitch, you will chain 1 and single crochet back all the way through the stitch marker. Once you're at the stitch marker, you chain 1 and single crochet all the way back once again. Once we have two rows of single crochets for these 24 stitches, I will start increasing to create the cloak and wrap it around our Mary. To do this, I will single crochet all around, but the first stitch I will always make an increase. Remember, we will be single crocheting back and forth, so you will single crochet twice into your first stitch and then single crochet all the way around. Once you're at the end of your stitch, chain one and single crochet twice into the first stitch. Single crochet back and repeat this until the cloak measures the same length as your Mary. I have worked approximately 20 rows to have the same length as Mary. Once the cloak is done, I will introduce the gold color to create an outline of gold around my cloak. To slip stitch, you just have to go through the loop, yarn over and pull through, go through the next loop, yarn over and pull all the way, and you have your first slip stitch. Next I will go through my loop, yarn over and pull through. Repeat this all around. When you get to the corners, you will do two slip stitches. You might need to force a bit your hook to pass through the tight loops. Once you get to the side, try to keep your loops as close as possible and the same size. keep slip stitching all the way through until we get to the back of our cloak once again. Once you're at the back, slip stitch and pull through. Grab a yarn needle and pass the yarn needle through the first slip stitch you have worked. This will close off the slip stitches as neat as possible. Fasten off and weave in the tail. Next, I will be creating the hands. To create the hand, I will use the white color for my body and the skin color. I will start off using the skin color. Make a magic ring and single crochet 6 into this magic ring. Pull the tail close to create a circle and single crochet all around for 3 rounds total. Once you have done 3 rows of single crochet, we will change to white. Tie together the end and then stuff them in, and then I will stuff them in order to be able to work more comfortably. Once your 10 rows of single crochets in white are done, to close the arm, I will single crochet through both sides. And create 2 arms. Next, I will show you how to single crochet across. To work the cross, I will chain 6, slip stitch and join to my first chain. Next, I will chain 10, and I will single crochet back into the circle we have just created. Now I will chain 6, single crochet back into the circle, chain 5 and single crochet back into the circle, chain 6 and single crochet back into the circle. And now you may fasten off and weave in the tail. Move the stitches around to shape the cross. For the rosary, I will chain 8 and single crochet into the third loop. Now chain 8 and single crochet back into the third loop from your hook. And repeat this until you have 4 beads. Now chain 8 and join back to the first chain that we have worked. Now to tie everything together, I will single crochet through to join the cross. Next, I will show you how to crochet the crown. I will start off by chaining 20. Join the last chain to the first chain to close it off and create a circle. Single crochet into the first 3 stitches and then increase and repeat this all around. For the next round, I will just single crochet into each stitch. Next, I will chain 5. Skip 4 stitches and slip stitch into the next. Repeat this all around to create small loops. Now I will single crochet all around. But once at the middle of my chain, I will chain 3, slip stitch back into that same space, and keep single crochet until my next chain. Once you have all the parts done, you will start sewing everything together. Before sewing everything together, I will be sewing on the eyes. I will pass the yarn needle with my blue colored yarn from the back of the head. Then change my yarn to white to create the base of the eye. And then I will change my yarn to black to create the outside and outline for my eye. Once the eyes are done, I will start sewing on the arms. Next, I will place the cloak and pin it down. I will only sew around the bottom of my Mary. Just to keep my cloak in place. Next, for the crown, I will pin it in place and then sew it on. I have bent the hand a slight bit to give the illusion that it's spraying. And we're done. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. I will see you in the next one. Bye guys.